Welcome to this video. Are you interested in why your vehicle diagnosis displays POAOD351? How is the error code interpreted by the vehicle? What does POAOD351 mean, or how to correct this fault? Today we will find answers to these questions together. Let's do this. First, let's look at the history of diagnostic fault code composition according to the OBD2 protocol, which is unified for all automakers since 2000. We divide the electric system of automobile into the four basic units: powertrain, body, chassis, network. This distribution is defined in the first character code. If the second character is expressed as zero, it is a standardized error. In the case of numbers 1, 2, 3, it is a more prestigious expression of the car-specific error. The third character specifies a subset of errors. The distribution shown is valid only for the standardized DTC code. Only the last two characters define the specific fault of the group. The add-on to the error code serves to specify the status in more detail. For example, a short to the ground. Let's not forget that such a division is valid only if the other character code is expressed by the number zero. Our website airbagreset.sk produces useful videos for you. You do not have to go through the OBD2 protocol anymore to know how to troubleshoot any car breakdown. You will find all the diagnostic codes that can be diagnosed in a Toyota vehicles, also many other useful things. The following demonstration will help you look into the world of software for car control units. You unbelievably can move the video a bit further. The error code is split into two bytes consisting of 16 bits. One bit is the basic unit that each computer works with. The bit has two logical states: 0, low level, 1, high level. By combining the first two bits, the basic character of the error code is expressed. The next two bits again determine the second character. The last bit styles of the first byte define the third character of the code. The second byte is composed of a combination of 8 bits. The first 4 bits determine the fourth character of the code, and the combination of the last 4 bits defines the fifth character. A single byte conceals 256 possible combinations. We now know in what way the diagnostic tool translates the received information into a more comprehensible format. The number itself does not make sense to us if we cannot assign information about it to what it actually expresses. So, what does the diagnostic trouble code POAOD351 interpret specifically Toyota car manufacturers? The basic definition is second row left retractor pretensioner, circuit resistance out of range. And now this is a short description of this DTC code. The occupant restraint controller ORC is a sensing and diagnostic module that is responsible for monitoring and managing hardwired inputs, outputs, bus messages, and contains the vehicle's dynamic sensor. The module contains the pre-programmed logic to determine if and when a restraint is to be deployed. The ORC monitors these systems at ignition on and for most systems, continuously during vehicle operation, communicating relevant status and data over the bus if the ORC detects a system failure or monitored value that is out of the allowable range. A corresponding DTC will be set and recorded, and the airbag warning lamp will be commanded on in the event of a vehicle crash which exceeds a predetermined level. This may or may not include restraints deployment. Crash data will be recorded and cannot be deleted. The early crash sensors, frontal crash sensors are located on the front crossmember. The remote acceleration sensors, B pillar sensors are located behind the trim of the B pillars. The door pressure sensors, if equipped, are located in the front doors, and the yaw and lateral sensors are internal to the controller. This diagnostic error occurs most often in these cases: left rear retractor pretensioner, circuits out of range, left rear retractor pretensioner, occupant restraint controller ORC. The Airbag Reset website aims to provide information in 52 languages. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned for the next video.